The Owen James Report is brought to you by...
Dear Santa, all I want for Christmas is a Barita Tuition Builder account. It can be in Jamaican or US dollars, that's fine with me. I know the returns will make it easy for mommy and daddy to afford school for me and give me a head start towards a brighter future. All they have to do is invest in the Barita Money Market Fund or the Barita FX Bond Portfolio and watch my tuition fund grow. So, this Christmas, give me the gift that keeps on growing, a tuition builder account from Barita.
Good evening. This is the Owen James Report. There has been an interesting development at the successful small loans financial company Access Financial Services. Mayberry Investments, which owned almost 50% of the shares, sold its over 135 million shares to Proven Investments, we understand, for over $1.2 billion, effectively swelling its bottom line considerably. This effectively makes Proven the single largest shareholder in Access Financial, a company started by Marcus James, the company's current CEO. The stock exchange's trading summary showed that Access Financial was today's dominant trader, accounting for 96% of the over 141 million shares which traded. Access Financial closed at $9, down a tenth of 1%. We won't speculate on how today's turn of events will impact on a current court matter between Mayberry and Access Financial Services CEO Marcus James. In an initial reaction to the sale of the shares, Mayberry's Gary Peart noted its success and said that after an initial investment of $38 million in 2006, the investment bank will earn approximately over 900 million Jamaican dollars or 8.34 million US dollars from today's transaction. Peart says Mayberry is now interested in finding new investments to deploy the proceeds profitably. On the wider market, that transaction, as well as gains by Proven and Scotia Group, pushed up the indices. The main JSE index advanced by 537 points, or 0.7%. 27 stocks traded, with 8 advancing, 10 declining, and 9 holding firm. The winners included Berger, up 19.3%. Grace Kennedy, Lasco Financial Services, the preference stock Proven 8%, Sagicor's Real Estate X Fund, and Scotia Group. The losers included Caribbean Producers, the day's big loser, down 2.8%, Hardware and Lumber, Jamaica Broilers, Jamaica Producers Lime, and Scotia Investments. On the foreign exchange market, the Jamaican dollar weakened against the benchmark American dollar, as well as the British pound, and strengthened against the Canadian dollar. Here are today's numbers. The US dollar strengthened by 4 Jamaican cents, closing at an average selling rate of $114.59, whilst the Canadian dollar weakened by 19 Jamaican cents to close at $97.58. However, sterling strengthened by 11 Jamaican cents to close at $177.21. On the international scene, it was a contrasting tale of two benchmarks on the crude oil markets. Over in Europe, Brent Blend crude fell by 30 cents to close at $57.58 a barrel. On the other hand, U.S. crude for February delivery, after hitting a 5.5-year low of $52.70 a barrel, later rebounded to trade at $54.58 a barrel. And that's the Owen James Report. Good evening.
The Owen James Report is brought to you by...
This Christmas, give me the gift that keeps on growing, a tuition builder account from Barita.